Here we go. Time for more net running. On the right, replicating perfection. An opponent I don't think I've played before. On the left, me, playing the same decks I've been playing. Not going to be doing that for too much longer, guys. You're going to see some new stuff pretty soon. But anyway, in this tournament, this is round three of the 20-sided store twice-monthly Netrunner tournament that took place on May the 4th, Sunday, 2014. I have lost three games in the first two rounds. So hopefully we can mount some sort of comeback. It's going to be a four-round tournament. I pretty much can't win now, so just playing whatevs. I'm just trying to prove to myself that, like, I didn't suddenly go from, you know, winning most of the games to complete garbage overnight. You know, but I'm playing against a relatively new player here. I don't think sorry, I don't remember your name. It's not someone I played before or someone who goes to the same meetups as me. It's someone who I presume has also lost three or four of the games they've played so far. So, you know, just as bad as I am. So here we go, bad versus bad. For some reason, there were a lot of replicating perfection decks at this tournament. Is this the only one I played against? Yeah, I think so. Unless I played against one in round four, which I guess we'll find out real soon and when I record the round four video. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what made it popular. Was it suddenly, right? Was it Caprice? Was it Honor and Profit, right? I don't know. But here comes the mulligan. So replicating perfection is actually sort of annoying for my deck. You know, that extra click to run the central and then bounce to the remote can get pretty annoying. Replicating decks also tend to nowadays, or you know, well, always, you know, run cards like, you know, pad campaign, which and marked accounts and stuff like that. But which, you know, you kind of want to trash, which is hard for me to do because I don't have a ton of money. But nowadays they run Sundew, which is must trash, right? You cannot let a Sundew happen if you want to have any chance, right? So, and it's very hard for me to must trash a Sundew. It's relatively easy against my deck to make a situation where you can protect a Sundew for at least a few turns. And that's just not something that you can allow, right? If you want to be have a competitively viable runner deck, you know, if the replicating reses a Sundew, you have to be able to trash it the next turn, right? Whether that's a run of a central followed by an inside job, or you have a full breaker suite and a ton of money, or something. So yeah. Well, I got a pretty good hand. I got a couple of Parasites and a Datasucker. But I'm not really willing, because my hand is good, right? I don't necessarily want to face check into Neural Katana right away. Plus, there's new cards out there. You know, I used to be less caring about that, right? Net damage doesn't kill you. Doesn't matter. But, that being said, there's new cards out there, like Shinobi, which I know he couldn't have rezzed, right? But they're the new Jinteki Ice are a little bit scarier than some of the old ones, right? Specifically a Koma Inu, right? Koma Inu is really the one that scares me off running right away, right? A Neural Katana is significantly less scary than a Koma Inu on the first turn, right? It's like I can Parasite it. But for a Koma Inu, that's not going to cut it, right? I need to be able to Parasite it while I'm on my way in. I can't let him res it, lose all my cards, and then Parasite it, right? So I got a clone ship, and I got two daily casts rocking. So I think the move here is to fill the Datasucker perhaps on Archives and draw enough cards to throw so that I can throw a Parasite into the trash, right? Then I can safely make a run and bring the Parasite out with the clone ship. And if it's an ice to where I don't have to, that I can face check safely, don't waste the clone chip on the parasite. Instead, install the one from hand. And that will, you know, because parasite is pretty much the ultimate weapon against Koma Inu. It's so weak. It's nice, you know. The turns that you install a daily cast, you feel like you're so poor, but then the turns where the daily casts pay out are so nice. He's throwing out a neural EMP. I guess he realizes he's not going to be able to kill me. Okay, so I ran archives just to run a central for the replicating ability. Now I'm running Jackson Howard. He's going to let me trash it. I do so. I'm afraid to run that card. It's probably a snare. You know, in some ways, a snare would help me put the parasites into the trash, turning on my clone ship parasite. Okay, all three daily casts somehow. That's just crazy, but it's going to be fun getting 6 credits for no clicks. Your turn, replicating. I see a sundew in that hand, but he doesn't really have any remote ice, and I don't think I see any ice in the hand. Is that a lot of agendas in the hand? Because I'm ready, willing, and able to run HQ. Alright, sets up a new remote. Draws a card. It's Caprice Nisei. Kind of annoying for me. And he sets up another remote. Okay. 3 daily casts. It's a lot of Reddit I'm reading right there. Drawing a card. Draw a card. I'm going to dirty laundry the archives, get a data sucker, and I net 3 credits. Turned a 2 into a 5. Yeah, the 2s and 5s are a similar color, so I keep them flipped over opposite sides, and the different side of the coins have different graphics. So by flipping the 5s over, that makes them significantly different enough from the 2s, not to confuse me or my opponent. And I'll throw out my really expensive Femme. I should have thrown out my Parasite. I just sort of, you know, I thought of throwing out the Parasite earlier, and then I forgot to actually do it, because it's so natural for me to throw out the Femme, right? That's 99% of the time I throw that out, because it's so expensive, you know. If I'm going to install it, I'm going to install it with a test run scavenge. I'm not going to install it for 9 credits from my hand. And I have a clone chip anyway. So he's installing. Okay, I'm pretty sure that's a Caprice Nisei, you know. But now that he's got 2 upgrades, right, am I really thinking that it's 2 Caprice Niseis? He's not allowed to have 2 at once. So, you know, of course I'm thinking there might be Hokusais in there. And, you know, usually replicating decks aren't going for damage, but I saw Neural EMP, so damage is on the table. Right? Because he threw that Neural EMP away. I got another clone chip. That's nice. Oh, I have a Stimhack, so I could... Was that what I was thinking? Was that I was going to Stimhack that Femme? Into existence. Right? That's not a bad idea. Not a bad idea at all. Okay. There we go. Finally, I throw the parasite away. Okay. So that's the other benefit of parasite, at least with this one ice centrals, right? Is that if there is a Caprice Naysay, I can run and play the Caprice game repeatedly without having to break ice over and over and over, making it much less taxing. I can basically run, destroy the ice, run until Caprice is dead. The only problem is I won't be able to build data suckers on the runs in which I lose the Caprice game. So. I think he wanted to try to use the Neural EMP, and I said I didn't run. Yeah, listen, everyone in the world who plays Netrunner, this is something you have to understand, right? You know, I've said the motto, right? Damage that doesn't kill you doesn't matter. Okay, so if you're a corp, for a runner, that means don't be afraid of damage that's not going to kill you. Oh, he's bringing his Jackson Howard back out with his interns. Okay. Oh, is that why he's throwing away his Neural EMPs? Freaking he can get them later. Okay, new guy, drawing three instead of two by accident. Okay. As a corp, right? Also, damage that doesn't kill the runner also doesn't matter, right? I mean, you might be design some crazy deck that can damage them so much that they run out of cards. That's very, 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 very unlikely. If someone just has one levy in their deck, that your whole deck is useless, right? So that's not viable, especially since levy's not unpopular. It's not super popular, but it's not unpopular. Ah, good, Tsurugi, a victim for Parasite. Not quite Koma Inu, but not Koma Inu either. I will continue. Ah, it's not Caprice. Ah, ha, 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 ha. All right, damage me. I notice a lot of corps, especially players that are newer, will play cards such as Scorcher, Punitive Counterstrike, Neural EMP, etc., and deal damage to the runner, non-lethal damage, right? You play a Punitive Counterstrike that costs you a ton of credits and a card. You can't, you know, and you damage the runner, sure, but you didn't kill them. And now, what happens? They aren't dead, and you're down one Counterstrike. So now you've basically just given up on your possible opportunity to kill them with that card later. That's a card you could have killed them with and won the game with, and you just threw it away. Right? Those Neural EMPs, hold on to them. He had with three Neural EMPs. If I ended any turn with only two cards in hand, boom, boom, boom. Right? I don't have a Deus Ex out right now. I'm not really too worried to get one either. And now I'm indexing because I cleared off R&D. And did he counter the indexing with Jackson Howard? Is that why we're shuffling? That's fine. Oh no, did I run Jackson? What did I even do? Oh well. Yeah, I started talking my little mini rant about damage cards, right? If your Scorched Earth isn't going to end the game, don't play it. Unless you already have like an archive memories or something, or you know, you're doing the crazy combo, so it doesn't matter that you already played it. You know, unless you have a situation like that, but you know, when you play that damage card, it is gone. So if it doesn't kill the runner, you just basically gave up an opportunity to kill the runner to do, and instead to just do a few damage. Did I get the daily cast already this turn? Whatever. Okay, second data sucker. Running somewhere. Oh, data sucker, click one, click two, running archives. All right, that should be enough to take care of any ice I see. I have the clone ship for the parasite. Where am I running? Oh, I'm getting rid of this. I'm running the sundew. Yeah, move your ice back, dude. You're confusing me. He doesn't res, I trash sundew. And don't run last click, even against replicating, so draw a card. Okay. Hedgy hedge. For someone who hasn't rezzed any ice, doesn't really have a lot of credits. It's mostly just installed a bunch of remotes and stuff. Not even used them. Okay, protect some other card that's been sitting there forever. What ice? Run R&D. Toll booth. Perfect. I paid the toll. Clone ship. Parasite for one. Kill. Oh, for two, because I already installed the clone ship this turn. It's a snare. He spent all his money raising the toll booth. He could not activate the snare. Now I'm running some other card. He doesn't have enough money to activate that snare, so now I can run all of his other cards freely. I run. It's a sundew. I trash it. I run that server. Can he res that? Unless it's a pop-up window. That's a sundew. I'll trash that too. Why didn't he res those sundews? I guess since I would trash them immediately and he was just trying to get them on the table. And now that he doesn't have enough credits to snare anyone, I was not afraid to run all of them. Alright, so now he's got one credit. I probably should, you know, when he only has one credit, doesn't Caprice cost, like, you know, even if he can res, I don't even know what Caprice costs to res. I think it's two, so he can't even res her, right? So I'm pretty sure that's Caprice or Hokusai. I could have run there to trash that. See, I'm running HQ now. He's not rezzing, and he only has three credits, so I know I can't be snared. Right? There's an upgrade. I access the upgrade first. It is Caprice. Trash that for one. Goodbye. Now I'll access HQ. Yoink. It's a Hogu Neural EMP. How many of those does he have? I'll run R&D. Is he gonna res? No. Snare, trash it, because you can't activate it. Run R&D again. Okay. That's that. Draw. Okay. Well, even if he gets four credits now, he doesn't really have any snares left to activate. I mean, I've already seen two go in the trash. He's got one left at most. And I get the feeling he can't res his ice. He's spending money. Oh, no, he's taking three. Taking three. SMC. Run R&D. Is he gonna res? He's thinking about it. It's a katana. Okay, cool. He still now doesn't have enough money to activate snares. I'll clone ship my... Oh, can I SMC? I'd rather use an SMC than a clone ship, if possible. The question is there a parasite left in my deck? There it is. Pew! Now, why would I rather do that? It costs more money. Well, a clone ship has many other uses, right? And also, removing the parasite from my deck, my stack, makes it the density of cards that I want to draw a little better, right? I already have parasite, so get that one out of there. It cost a few more credits, but that's not a big deal. You know, I might need that clone ship later, right? I value a clone ship just a lot higher than an SMC. All right, there's a Hokusai grid in HQ. Okay, so look at this game, and you can see, you know, I'm it's a pretty strong position I'm in right now, right? He can't protect anything. He doesn't have a lot of money. Have I scored anything? But I only have 3 credits here, right? And I just spent 2 to get this Grimoire. Now, everyone else besides me plays Desperado instead of Grimoire. And when I first started playing, why did I play Grimoire? Well, number one, 2 memory instead of 1, which you can see with SMC and the need to install Inti and stuff like that, that extra memory comes in way, way handy. Sometimes you need 2 data suckers and an Inti and a Femme and a Parasite. That's all of it. You know, and then you got 2 data suckers and an Inti and you got to bring out an SMC. Sometimes you just need all 6 memories. But lately, I just need the 1 memory lately, right? I don't necessarily always need the 6. You know, the 5 is not bad. 4 is not enough, but 5, I think, can get the job done in a lot of cases. But early on when I was playing the Grimoire, that extra virus counter from the Grimoire was huge. It was huge. It made the difference between winning and losing in a lot of games, right? I'd be like, 1 virus counter short. Nope, I got it, right? I'd clone ship a Parasite at the end of their turn onto a rezzed ice. My turn would start. It would get a 2nd virus counter. Boom, that would be enough to run and trash it. And it would be awesome, right? Throw up my Atman, I don't need. Nowadays, that extra counter isn't really coming in handy at all. Either A, I have so many data suckers because the servers are wide open, right, that an extra one from a Grimoire doesn't really make a difference. Or B, I have none at all, pretty much, because I can't get any because I'm locked out, right? So in either of those situations, you know, the one from Grimoire might matter if there's like an ice wall and I have to get rid of it, and it's, you know, or it's a strength to an Enigma and I have to get rid of it now. But people are playing more Quandary and less Enigma, right? And I think that alone has made Grimoire less useful. I don't need, you know, that's what I used to do a lot. That's the one kind of breaker. I have an Inti, I have a Femme. I don't have a decoder of any kind. So I need to Parasite away Enigmas and things. So when everyone is playing Enigma at strength 2, the extra Grimoire one, you know, clone ship Parasite, 1 from Grimoire, 1 from the start of my turn, would kill the Enigma instantly. But now that everyone plays Quandary instead of Enigma, I don't need that as much. So, and also, I'm getting into a lot of situations like this where I'm getting the thing that I want, which is open servers, right? R&D is open, right? Corps are poor. I get what I want. And if I get what I want, I'm getting lots and lots of runs and accesses to fill up those data suckers. Look how many are on there right now. 6? Okay, so there's at least 6 data suckers there. You know there's been more because I've spent some, right? But I've had at least 6 successful runs. I have 3 credits right now. If I had a Desperado instead of Grimoire, I mean, sure, I didn't get to play that Grimoire until later in the game, but assuming I, you know, got it at a reasonable time, even half the credit, even instead of 6, so instead of 9 credits total right now, 6 credits total right now, sure, I'll take it. Okay, so here's the mistake I was talking about earlier. I scored a 2-pointer. He plays Counter-Strike. Okay. Play your Counter-Strike. I'll take 2 damage. Do you have another Counter-Strike? No. Nope. So you just spent a bunch of money to make me lose 2 cards. I'll take that. I'll take that all day. If you give me a runner card that says discard a card at random, corp loses credits, I will play that card all day long in every single deck that I have. So if you play that card for me, right? The only card I don't want you to be able to play is corp spends money, runner loses game. That is a card I don't want to have existing. But, right? So I've seen the Counter-Strike now, so I play the one Plascrete I was holding that he didn't damage away. Just to dissuade any future Counter-Striking. Because when I see the Counter-Strike, I think he's got three-pointers, and I'm poor. But yeah, so going back. Everyone plays Desperado but me, but I think I'm switching to Desperado, right? The Grimoire is not as useful as it was in when people were playing stronger ice, and in games where I'm locked out of servers, you know, the Grimoire or the Desperado, neither one is really going to help, right? So that's how it's going to be. Sorry, Grimoire. You know, the pile of credits I would get from a Desperado install compared to the one memory benefit of the Grimoire, it's just not even close anymore. Okay, so yeah, see, I need money. I got to fill Katie. If I had a Desperado, maybe I wouldn't even need Katie. Maybe. We'll find out. Okay, so I didn't run. Why didn't I run, right? It's like I can do pretty much anything I want. It's because they didn't have any money. I still need money to get that parasite out. And I need, you know, I don't need money to not get Counter-Strike because I have the Plascrete, but... Interns? The Sundew. That's interesting. You gonna res the Sundew? Maybe? There you go. And then you're gonna get your money back immediately. Because you're replicating perfection, you get your Sundew money no matter what. There it comes. I'm drawing a bunch of cards. What am I looking for? I don't know. An Atman, an SMC, what am I looking for? I also think this is a situation, he's going so slow, and I'm sort of letting him go slow, where clearing virus counters might not have been a bad idea on his part. But, you know, new players, that's a thing. You know, I didn't learn that that was even a thing. You know, I definitely missed it. I sort of saw it when reading the instruction manual and recognized it and then forgot it once I was actually playing the game. And it wasn't until I lost a tournament because I forgot it was a thing. Well, that's the tournament game. I wasn't going to win that tournament. I lost a game in a tournament because I forgot that clearing virus counters was a thing. And so... Right, empty Katie, install SMC, run somewhere, run a central, I can't run a remote. R&D. A Yagura. I think I'll let that happen. Am I going to let it happen? Or am I going to parasite it away? I let him do it. Net damage doesn't kill, doesn't matter. Will I access the card? No. What am I doing? What am I doing? I don't want to run less click, but I'm going to run the remote with the advanced card in it. It's a Tsurugi. Okay. I'll parasite that away. Or will I? Or will I? Or will I? I had to do something. Come on. What am I doing? I don't know why this is hard for me to think about. Oh, I think it's because if I try to install an Atman for 2, then I have to pay 4 to break all the subroutines of the Tsurugi. And then, if that's a June bug, I won't be able to get my Deus X and not die. I don't have enough money to do all those things. And I don't want to use my Parasite on that Tsurugi. Because... I want to save it for that Yagura on R&D and play indexing. Right? Oh, I also, yeah, that's what I want. If I get the 0 Atman, I don't even have to, you know, it's like I'm sort of running low on Parasite, right? So it's like I don't want to blow them all, right? Okay, so here, I'm breaking the 3 net damage subroutines. And now he can pay a credit to let me not end the run if he so desires. Don't I have to use 2 data suckers? Isn't this Tsurugi strength 2? Did I use them? I think I might have used them already. Oh no, there I'm using them. No. He's doing some net damage? I don't know what I'm doing. I have no idea what happened here. Why am I doing this weird thing? Whatever. I don't know. I guess I was just really afraid of the June, you know, even the one advanced June bug just in that weird situation. Okay. So he... What is he doing? He's scoring. Okay. I think it must have been a Nisei because he moved it where we can't see it. I gotta remember to remind people to keep things in the field of view of the camera. It just seems sort of rude sometimes to tell your opponent, like, look, no, don't do what you're used to. Do what I put your cards where I tell you to put them. Okay. Why is this game so ridiculously slow? Is the score only 2-2? Wow. Well, I've got a fistful of indexing, and R&D is effectively wide open, so the slowness of this game probably is about to go away. Drawing a bunch of cards to stay safe, filling Katie so I have enough money. Taking even more money. All right, so yeah, I think I'm just trying to get enough money to go run multiple times for some indexing. And oh, I think I also want to trash the Sundew. I think I want to trash Sundew. All right, make your remote really, really strong with a million eyes. You do that. Okay, empty Katie. Click one. Click two. Indexo! I'm going to... Oh, pay two credits to break the Agura with my zero Atman. Look at a bunch of cards. Are there no agendas there? Is it just like a snare I'm going to put on top of his deck? For him to draw. Oh, nope. Is that an NEPD I see there? Okay. Run R&D again. Wait, why did I take a click back? Yeah, run R&D again. Pay two to break the Agura. Pay four to take the NAPD. There we go. Why does this game feel like it's going so slowly? Why am I thinking so hard? Watching this game now, it's just like, yeah, just do it. What are you doing, man? Like, what was I saving my parasite for, if not that Yagura? Okay, so now he's got this remote going on. And I don't have any money to run it. And I know R&D is fruitless because, I just indexed it. Take a third credit, okay. Dirty Laundry, the archives. That should be my whole turn. All right, I think he scored a priority rec. Or no, he scored something that cost five advancements. So I assume the score, I think the other one must have been Nisei or NAPD or something. So I assume the score is 5-4 right now. Gonna run archives. There's a Grim there. Okay. Oh, I see what happened. It was a priority rec that he scored. He said that he forgot to res an ice with it. I said, what ice do you want to res? Go for it. Right? Because I hadn't really run since then. He wanted to res the Grim, and he thought he wouldn't get the bad pub. And I was like, no, you're going to get the bad pub if you res the Grim, even with your priority rec. And he's like, oh. So instead, he res the Neural Katana, right? You know what he just told me? I mean, sure, okay, he revealed there was a Grim on Archives, which is a really good Grim placement. I've talked about program trashing destroyers on Archives before. But by using the priority rec on the Neural Katana, he's revealed that every ice on the table that he has is less to res than Neural Katana, right? He doesn't have any big ice out there, right? Up. Another tricky business. A chum followed by a Neural Katana. The chum is always a tough situation for the Parasite deck, because if I just Parasite that Katana, right, only, directly, then the chum will hit me, right? So what I need to do is I'm going to use my Atman and with a bunch of data suckers to break the boosted up katana, right? I break the subroutine, but also, in addition to breaking the subroutine, right, I will use a parasite and a bunch of data suckers to trash the katana. Right. And that includes the two extra ones, or at least it should have. I don't know if I messed up. I wasn't paying close attention there. Because the chum boosted its strength by two. Right. And see, I really want to parasite something behind a chum, especially if it gets the chum all the way to the back, because now the server is wide open. Right. Effectively, the chum is now useless. What am I looking for in archives? Stop it, me. Me, why are you being so dumb and playing so slowly and stupidly? What the hell are you looking for, me? Oh my god. This is how you can tell when I'm, you know, doing well and doing poorly, right? It's like when you watch a game that you played after the fact on video and you say, man, whoever that is should have done this, and then that person who should have done that is you, and then in the video you do exactly what you just told yourself to do. You're doing good. Here, I'm not doing what I'm saying I should be doing, right? I'm doing all sorts of weird stuff, right? Worried about weird stuff that doesn't matter. Why am I letting him keep this sundew, for instance? Oh my god, I should have trashed that thing a million years ago. You know, look how much money he's made off that sundew. Without that, he'd be so poor right now, he wouldn't be able to res nothing. You know, why did I let him score those agendas in that remote that I could have easily taken? His centrals are wide open. Is the indexing over yet? I should play an indexing again. Okay, make another remote. Go for it. Oh my god, I just want this game to end because it's so ridiculously long. Why is this game taking so long? Alright, indexing again. And what do we see? Do we see winning? I see an NEPD. I run again. That's game. Oh, finally. Oh my god, that took so long for that game. Or at least it felt long. Maybe it's just replicating perfection makes it feel long. Well, I won. Oof. Oh, was that only the first game of this round? Did I not play Corp yet? Oh man. Oh man. That game didn't just feel long, it was long. Oh my god. I'm looking at my time codes in my video software here, and it's like 42 minutes or something, right? And I'm like, oh, okay, well, this second game feels really long. It's like, no, that was the first game. There were like 20 minutes left only for this second game of this round. Yep, look, there I'm going to get my NBN. Oh boy. Take back, don't forget your Jackson Howard, dude. Okay, well, whew, this is why, right? Slow decks are not viable in tournaments, right? Okay, two fast decks. This shouldn't take as long, right? We should be good here, right? Right? I hope so. Well, just because you're in a hurry doesn't mean you don't have time to shuffle well, right? No point in, you know, just rushing into a game with a poorly shuffled deck and then the game is garbage, right? Play fast, but make it good. Yeah, okay, so what lessons do we learn from that first game? I think one thing is that you notice that, you know, I haven't done, you know, this poorly at a tournament in a while. So, because I was losing already, especially coming off, you know, demoralizing games in the previous round, I think that psychologically affected me going into the third round. You know, you can see I was doing weird stuff, and I was not on the top of my game at all, right? Other things. Yeah, I guess, you know, Desperado. The people who were playing Desperado when I was playing Grimoire, well, they're right. it's time to make a change. Replicating perfection, I still don't think it's good enough to win tournaments. I do love it on paper as an identity. I really want to do some things with it. But I don't think, you know, it's popular suddenly thanks to Caprice and some other cards. But I don't think it's for real. Not yet, anyway. Okay. And I'm going to mulligan that because even a player who plays Replicating Perfection knows how to play an account siphon. And I have to stop it. Anyone can play an account siphon. You just have to have one. And they're in the core set, so everyone has them. And you just got to play one. And that's it. You'll be in the money. The big money. Shuffle it up real good, but hurry it up. I want to go to bed. Okay. Well, that looks like a much better hand. Install my two ice. Pop up Windows and R&D for the win, always. And is that a transaction I have? Yeah, I have a habit of putting my R&D in my HQ much too close to the edge of my table, and then I have no room for archives. Edge fund. No sweepstake for Andromeda. Oh, well. I wasn't mulliganing to try to get... Well, I was kind of hoping to get one, but I didn't mulligan because I didn't have one. I mulliganed because I couldn't protect the house, right? And after, you know, getting hit with that... planned assault earlier, right? I didn't want to leave either server open on turn one against Andromeda, who's very likely to have a planned assault and would be able to planned assault indexing or planned assault Maker's Eye or planned assault account siphon, right? I want to have an ice on both servers turn one against Andromeda nowadays, no matter what, because planned assault exists. Sure, gambling. Okay, so here he starts doing stuff. That I'm not prepared for, which is access to Global Sec and Underworld Context on turn one. And I'm like, damn it, he's going to start getting a credit every turn. That's really annoying. But here's the thing, is my deck, like I said, is really weak to Wizard. But from the last round. In round two, I talked about how my deck is weak to Wizard, and it's weak to Link. But no one plays Wizard, and no one plays Link. And that's why my NBN deck works. And even though he just played a Link, I totally forgot. Because I haven't had practice playing against people who play Link. Because people don't play Link. They don't play it. It's a meta play. So here comes some, you know, guy who's not in the meta. And he wants to play Underworld Context. And by association with that, he's playing Link. He runs my remote. And I'm thinking, yeah, Caduceus, yeah. Oh, wait. Oh, 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 shit. Damn it. He's As soon as I res it, that's when I realize he's got Link. Oh, this isn't going to work. This isn't going to work at all. This is a useless ice. Okay, so spend. He's got two Link. So yeah, you want to spend three or let me have three? He let me have the three. Okay. Trace two. You know, how much am I going to boost this end the run? He sure gambled twice. And he got the under. He's got 11 credits and two Link. And I've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He can get in no matter what. And even if I spend all 9, what is he going to do? Run again? Okay. So it was just a breaking news. But so what I was trying to do there was I was thinking, I have an ice now. I'm going to put my breaking news down. He's not going to be able to take it. And I'm going to trash that Global Sec or that Underworld Context with my breaking news. Oh, it's going to be so sweet. I just rushed into it because I'm so used to... you know, being able to do that right away in a game. And it just so happened the ice I had was Caduceus, and I forgot until he actually ran it that that's not going to make it happen. Runs R&D. Thank you for trashing Mr. Howard. That's going to cost you some money. But now that, yeah, but that Underworld Context is and that Link are going to bother me the rest of the game. Right? Look, I'm sitting there with an ash in my hand, and I'm like, oh, shit, this ash is not really helpful, is it? Not as helpful as usual. Okay, so I'm rezzing my Tollbooth right away. Boom. Stay out of HQ, you criminal, you. And I was holding an agenda. Or two. Am I holding two? I think I might be an AstroScript and a Beal. I just don't want him in HQ right now. I'll even res a Tollbooth to keep him out. Okay. What do I got there? Two useless ashes. Draw another card. Is that a not useless ice? Alright, I'm going to put on Archives. Why do I put on Archives? Sneak Doran. I'm worried about Sneak Doran, because that is a card that is played a lot. And is that a Sand Sen I'm putting in the remote? Okay. Whew. Okay. So, made some mistakes early on, forgetting how to, you know, what to do if the opponent plays Link. Mostly cry. But, you know, not going to give away a point again. Not going to do it. I don't like the money he's getting from Underworld Contacts. But that's okay. He's taking some money. 2 credits. And another access to GlobalSec. Well, if I ever got him tagged and was able to trash, I would have trashed the access to GlobalSec. But now there's two of them. So it's even worse to try to trash those. I should trash the Underworld Context if I get a chance. Yeah, as he runs the Caduceus with his extra Link, I boost the first trace up. He denies it. The second trace is just at 2. Then there's a Sansan. Is he going to spend all his money to trash it? He does. But I succeeded in making him spend all his money. Right? But man, 2 access to GlobalSec. Oh, my Caduceus, just throw it in the garbage. At least he let me have the free res on it. Right? Okay. What am I going to do now? You know, I could try to use these useless ashes to try to get some money out of the Caduceus, right? Yeah, put one in and play Sweeps Week. Because he's got cards in his hand. Okay. Stupid. Yeah, I'm pointing at his head. I'm like, look at you, you playing Link. Ugh. Killing me. Killing me with that Link. Please run my Caduceus. I'm, even though you have Link, I might be able to milk some money out of it because I'm NBN. There's an ash there that you can't trash. Take. No, he gets a credit from Underworld, and then he takes 4 for a total of 5. Man, if only that was an AstroScript in that server. Okay, install. Draw 2 with Jackson. That looks like an AstroScript to me. I have some real ice. I have a useless Draco. Completely useless Draco. Just throw that in the garbage. He's got Link. Draco is useless. Well, not 100% useless. Right? I mean, if I put it on HQ, I can still res it, which would help fight against account siphons, right? Because if the first time he account siphons, I can res it and spend all my money to make it really big. Then on subsequent account siphons, it would be so big the trace would almost certainly fire. And even though, you know, whether the trace wins or not against his Link doesn't matter, because I can just dump all my money into the trace to prevent him from siphoning it away. He got a hostage. I guess he's getting another Underworld Context with that hostage. I am guessing correctly. Oh, God. You know, when you have a certain meta You know, people are playing certain kinds of decks. You build your deck to beat those decks. You just see scissors everywhere. So you play rock and you go, yeah, I'm the best. It's like, no, you're not actually the best. You're just the only person who noticed that everyone is playing scissors and decided to play rock. Some guy walks in playing paper and is just like, who plays paper? Seriously? Oh my God. How am I losing to this? I beat everybody because everyone plays scissors and you play rock. But anyone who plays paper, it's not going to be good for you. So, all right. Got paper on the right and rock on the left. Well, at least my toll booth is standing strong. I haven't gotten siphoned. That's the only thing keeping me in this game. Oof, I'm surprised you haven't gone to time yet. I got 0 points. Well, the video isn't yet an hour long. Well, 65-minute rounds, right? And so I guess there was at least 5 minutes at the beginning of the video that were not part of the where we weren't playing. So I guess there's at least like 10 minutes left. And more than it's 10, 15 minutes left in this round at least. So it's not too bad. But yeah, it felt long. Mostly because usually we finish with plenty of time to spare. Okay, setting up this remote. Hopefully that's a real ice I put there. I hopefully didn't be doing anything stupid and put the Draco there. And I know the ash trace won't be that strong, but... Okay, he's running it. Is it a real ice I have? It is. It's an Eli. What a, you know, usually I only like an Eli on a central. But at least in this case, right, I've got the ash. So... With the Ash situation and the Eli, if he wants to do the strategy of trashing Ash and then running, double-clicking the Ash again on the set, you know, you can't, double-clicking the Eli, hitting Ash, trashing Ash, you can't run and double-click it again. So Eli plus Ash isn't bad on the remote. Usually Eli for me is a central-only kind of guy because he's so porous. But anyway, I was able to squeak out that Beal. I really just wanted it out of my hand. Here he comes. Oh, God. He's dropping an R&D interface against my pop-up window. Yep. I'm getting ready to show you two cards, guy. Let's go. I'll take my pop-up money. And you're going to score points? Nope. And... Is it something you can't trash, maybe? All right. I survived that. I'm holding the Astro, but I guess I'm afraid to try to score it. With an Eli there. But I mean, if I had been brave enough, I would have scored it, right? I scored the Beal. Why wouldn't I? I would have scored an AstroScript just the same. Bravery is rewarded. You know, that if I had played well, that would have been an Astro over there on the side, not a Beal. Okay. Draw. Oh, another pop-up window, you say. Well, yes, I will install that in R&D. Would you like to use your R&D interface and give me a huge pile of money? See, and this is what I was talking about this during another game. When you run and you access a card and it's ice, and then the corp installs an ice, that's usually the ice you just saw. And in this case, it actually was the ice he just saw. He just saw a pop-up window. I installed an ice. Yes, the ice you just saw is the ice I installed. He probably even knows it. But it's like, oh, you really want to use your R&D interface to see two cards, one of which you've already seen, and give me two credits? Why, thank you. Then again, it's sort of free for him with the Underworld Context, but I guess he'd be giving me his Underworld Context money each turn. All right, special order. Now he's getting breakers. The game is happening. A Keymaster. Uh-oh. Account siphon incoming. Warning. Warning. But you know what? That's okay. For him to get through that toll booth is going to cost him 3, 5, 6, 9 credits. No, 4, 5 to break and 3, 8 credits. 8 credits with Keymaster to break the toll booth, right? He could do an inside job, shut down account siphon. That is a possible play on his part. And not a bad one. So I better be able to ice up that HQ. Maybe I should put the Draco there. Did I draw another protective ice? You know, I could put an Ash there, too. That would protect against siphoning, because I could always res it and dump my money into it. Draw two, looking for some ice. I don't think I saw any, but I got a Sand, so I'll put that in the remote. And Jackson again. I should have Jackson before installing the Sand. Okay, throw some stuff out. Jackson that I can just get back with Jackson. A Draco that I can't use at all. Beal, just to, if he starts running HQ. Yeah, okay. So he doesn't score. I'll hold my AstroScript. So if I get some money, if he runs R&D, I'll be able to sand it, right? I don't think he's going to account siphon. Oh, he is going to account siphon right through my toll booth. Okay. I have 5 credits, so... He's going to spend all 8. Okay. I lose 5. You get 10. Ah, but right before he siphons, I spend 2 to res Ash. I didn't have enough to res the Sansan, which I would have liked to do. If I would have had 6, I would have resed the Sansan. But I only had 5, so he decides he's not going to siphon for the 3 credits to get 6. Which is good news. Good news, everyone. I couldn't run the trace on that Ash because he wasn't running that server, but I was still able to blow 2 credits. I still think the absolute best anti-siphon card is Private Contracts, right? Okay, he shuts down the toll booth, of course. Criminals. But he didn't inside job shut it down. He just ran it and shut it down, which is why he's poor now. And he runs HQ, and my AstroScript, don't touch that. Ugh. So even with the really, really inefficient Keymaster, he takes out my toll booth. Okay, now I'll put another ice on HQ. What ice did I put there? Hopefully not the useless Draco. I'll set up another remote. I'll have another AstroScript in my hand? Oh, man. And I'll draw 2 with Jackson. I could really use some transactions here. I've had like 1 hedge and 1 sweep. You know what else would be nice? Dude, you know for a fact that I have 2 pop-up windows in R&D and you have an R&D interface. Please run my pop-up windows. Why are you not running through them? They're there for a reason. Yes, use your underworld contacts and run my pop-up windows. Come on. Please. Oh, is he running Jackson Howard or Archives? One or the other. So I'm going to use Jackson no matter which one it is. Take back, I guess, the agenda, the Jackson Howard, and something else. Okay. I guess he was running the Jackson Howard. Desperado. Cool, you're broke. I hope you see an NAPD just like that one there when you try to use your R&D interface. Run HQ, ice wall. Yeah, stay out. Stay out. You thought you were getting into HQ, but you're not. Ice wall's getting it done. It's 2-3. Okay. Can I get anything going on here? Is another useless Caduceus in my hand? Oh my god. Well, he has no money, right? Even for someone with Underworld Contacts and Link and a Desperado that he hasn't used Desperado yet. He is surprisingly broke. All right, so I have no means of getting money, but that's all I really need right now is money, so I take 3 credits. If I could just get enough, end my turn with 8, I could score off the stupid Sansan. Run my pop-up windows, holy crap. Why are you not running the stupid pop-up window? You have an R&D interface. Oh my god, please. Sure, take a bunch of money, I don't care. Oh my god. I have a pad campaign. All right. That's going to get me some money. And I'm going to take even more credits. Just, you know, I can't. Oh god. Try. Fine. Good. Trash my pad campaign. At least you'll be broke. Run my pop-up windows, please. This is another part of the problem. Right, is that when you play, you know, there are certain behaviors that, you know, players who are good at the game and win a lot will exhibit. So you start to play when you're good, you know, you play expecting those behaviors, right? Like on R&D with one pop-up window, an unresed ice, and another card which the runner is perfectly capable of predicting to be a pop-up window because they ran and accessed a pop-up window, and then I immediately drew and installed a card, right? So they should know that it's 2 pop-up windows, and they have an R&D interface, and they have 2 underworld contacts. Wouldn't, you know, sure, you're giving me the money that I need, right? But at the same time, wouldn't you run to access 2 cards? It could be AstroScripts. I know I would. Yeah, it's like, yes, I know this is really, really helping you by giving you money with stupid pop-up windows, and I... But I'm still going to get a ton of accesses, and it's totally worth it. Maybe I'll just win, and it won't matter that you have all that money. But he's not doing it. All right, he's got the corroder. He's running HQ, but dude, I have enough to res the toll booth now. Remember? Oh, but he doesn't have 3 credits, so he doesn't pay the toll. Okay. You're gonna need 9 credits. I'll keep taking 1. Install for 2. Take 1. Is that 3 pop-up windows I now have on R&D? Run them! Holy crap, run them. Oh my god. He's just taking a bunch of money. Oh my god. I'm also just taking a bunch of money. Why can't I draw a transaction to save my life? Oh my god. Just 1 hedge fund, 1 sweep, please. Please. Account siphon incoming. But actually, this account siphon may go differently. A sharpshooter. Okay. What I draw now? Not a transaction? Oh, it is a transaction. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, so here's my strategy. If the account siphon comes in, right? Did he forget his underworld contacts? No, he's getting them now. All right, the account siphon comes in. Boom, there it is. Okay. Yeah, I got enough money now this time. All right, yeah, spend it all, breaking all those. Boom, yeah. Okay, how much money you got left? I'm going to res... my sand before you siphon me. the thing I was one credit short of doing the previous time. You want to siphon my last four? Okay, he siphons my last four. Gaining 8 and 2 tags. Is he removing the tags? He's removing the tags. Okay. Cool. Very cool. Run R&D. Yes. Pop-up window. Yes. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Oh, yes. Oh, my pop-up windows. Yes. My Sansan is rezzed, and I had no money, but now I have 3 money. Oh, thank God. Oh, my God. Oh. Yeah, trash that pad campaign. Sure, take that breaking news. Oh, big deal. Big deal. You got 4 points. Congratulations. Oh, it's a miracle. It's a miracle. Install, advance, breaking news, and trash and underworld contact. Goodbye. That was the only way I was ever going to breaking news him, was was with the Sansan. Because I can't defend the remote against Link. I just can't. Oh, you're having a little trouble over there now. Look how fast that game swung around. Just running the pop-up windows once was all I needed. That was all I needed. Take 3. Whew. And look, he ran HQ a lot. Probably more than any other server. Oh, yeah. Spend all your money on an R&D interface. Yeah. Oh, are you going to fill my pop-up windows up again? Yes, thank you. Thank you. All right, you can see a whole bunch of cards. Yep. Yep, I'm holding all the agendas. There aren't going to be any in there. Yep. There are not going to be any in there, my friend. Is it my turn? Yep. Filtering out my archives here. It's hostaging another underworld contact, maybe? No, Katie? Okay. It's taking Katie hostage. And then, he's broke. Boom. AstroScript. Boom. Next turn. Game over. What? Somehow I recovered. Look, that pop-up window. It seems like not... look how big a deal that was. He ran it twice. And he really, you know, that was enough. That was all I needed him to do, was run the pop-up windows twice. That's all I needed. And that basically turned on the win for me. That, the smallest margin, right? Boom. Game over. Done. Whew. Oh, thank you for finally running the pop-up window. But you see, even against a count siphon, right? See, that, you know, that is what the deck is made to do. It's not, it can't, it counters the meta, right? The account siphon. I can deal with the account siphon, right? The R&D interface. I can deal with the R&D interface, right? The Link caused me problems. But that was mostly because of a misplay. If I just didn't drop that Caduceus on the first turn, right? Which was basically, you know, I wouldn't have, you know, if I would have recognized that it was basically so worthless with his Link, and not played it, I could have done a lot better. I wouldn't have been dragged into that late game there. But yeah, he played that Sharpshooter, and I was like, my Ichi archive trick is totally worthless now with your Sharpshooter. Why are you playing a Sharpshooter in a criminal deck? But you think about it, Sharpshooter is one influence. It protects against those destroyers, which can really ruin a criminal's day, and simultaneously protects against the power shutdown, because it only caused one to install a Sharpshooter. So you know, from this, I recognize that's a really good criminal splash there. But yeah, his mistake, I guess, not trashing the sand when he could have. You know, account siphoning, but never actually, I don't think he accessed a card in HQ even once, and I was holding agendas, right? I was holding them. And there was a time period where there was an ice wall, and I couldn't res the toll booth, and he could have just run to get some HQ accesses, but instead, he was just single-mindedly trying to build up for that siphon again, right? I'm pointing out the pop-up windows and everything, so oof, that game, all right. Let's go to the next round.